Hello again, Fanning here. Today I will talk about how you get a Gantt chart overview of your planner plans with the Roadmap service. The Roadmap service can give you an overview of all your projects in Project Online, Azure DevOps, and other services that are compatible with the Power Platform. Roadmap will give you a Gantt chart overview across traditional and agile projects and help you identify risk of delaying key milestones or deadlines. Very simply put, I will take our planner task, our roadmap, and use Flow to connect these. In the end of this video, I will show you how I created the flow. Let's start by creating the planner board. With the new board, all we need is a bunch of tasks. In the schedule view, we can quickly give all the tasks a start and a finish date. Next, go to project.microsoft.com and create a new roadmap. Add a new row and give it the same name as the planner board. Now wait a couple of minutes and let the flow do its thing. And voila, all our tasks are now in the roadmap. We can also set key dates to keep track of milestones or deadlines. Next, let's update some of the tasks to see the impact in the roadmap. That's it, just update the roadmap, and now we see the changes be applied to our tasks. Next, let's look into the actual flow that does all the work behind the scenes. In here, we see all the records we read out from the roadmap. We see all the project plans we read out, and I initialize a couple of variables to keep track of some data. Next thing we do is to loop over all the records of the roadmaps. And I just log some information here for debugging. And then I loop over all the project plans, or the planner plans. And here I have a condition saying, well, if I meet the planner plan that has the same name as the roadmap, I will engage it and update it. So now here I read all the roadmap links, and then I set a variable whether the link is created. And then I have a condition saying, well, if the name matches the name of the planner board, well, I say it is created. If it's not created at this point in time, I will go and create a new record in the roadmap links table corresponding. I have here a connection, which is a static UID because I don't have an actual connection ID for the planner board. After that, I go in and look at all the roadmap items. And then I set a variable if that roadmap item is already created. I also set the roadmap item ID. If it is created, if it's not created, I go in and create a new roadmap key with a start date and a finish date. If it's not created, I go in and update the start and the finish date of that roadmap item. That's all I have for now. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you like it, please hit that thumbs up button.